فؤادك الأيام فتى.
If a person, he became doubtful, is this his sister or is this a foreigner? Or is this his wife or is it a foreigner? He doesn't know who it is. He doesn't recognize the person. So here what's in it, halal and haram is present. The scholars, they said, فَدَرْءُ الْمَفَاسِدِ مُقَدَّمٌ عَلَى جَلْبِ الْمَصَالِحِ. Because the matter is mushtabah, it's unknown, unclear, 50-50. It can be your sister and it cannot be. The pushing away the harm takes precedence over bringing good. This is the qa'idah that they went and they used it for many practical things. And those are just examples. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he sees a different view in this issue. Ibn Taymiyyah yara ra'yan akhara fil mas'ala. Ibn Taymiyyah sees a different view in this issue. Wa yaqulu Ibn Taymiyyah holds the grounds, which is what? Inna al-i'tina'a al-shari'a bil ma'mur akthar min i'tina'i bil manhiyat. Ibn Taymiyyah took the opposite of what the jumhur took. He said that the Sharia gave more consideration towards what? The commands. Then it gave more consideration to the prohibitions. Ibn Taymiyyah said that. And he brought extensive evidences for his argument. But inshallah ta'ala, so we don't make the matter very long, you can find it in its madan, its places. But the Jumhur speech is stronger than Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. The view of the Jumhur, the majority, أقوى من قول الشيخ الإسلام بن تيمية رحمة الله عليه على الجميع. May Allah have mercy upon all of them. But Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah's speech is marjuh, it's weak. And the speech of the majority are correct. Also, one should know, for example, that this qa'idah, something else that falls under it, which is, what about if the masalih and the mafasid are equal to each other? You kept telling us that the masalih and the mafasid are, if one is higher than the other, we take the maslaha, no doubt. And within the maslaha, if there are two different levels, then we take what? Then we take the highest. What about if a maslaha and a mafsada? They're both equal. The maslaha and the mafsada are equal. What is the issue here? For example, with an example, it becomes clear this question, which is, a sick person who's unable to do wudu, or he can't find water and he can't find sand. Here's a mafsada. It's a mafsada, which is that he's going to have to pray without a tahara, because he doesn't have water, or he's unable, sorry, to use water. He's unable to do wudu, or he can't find water and sand. And he's a sick person. The person is sick. He can't do wudu because he's sick. And he can't find water and he can't find a turab. This is a mafsada. Because then it would lead that he would have to pray salah without tahara. That's a mafsada. And there's a maslaha here, which is the salah. They're standing here. Which of those are given precedence? Maslahatu salati, the benefits of the prayer, a'zamu min tilka al-mafsadati, the maslaha of the prayer takes precedence over the what? Of the mafsada, he will pray even if it's upon without tahara. He will pray even if it's without tahara. Another example would be obeying and listening to the ruler who is a transgressive ruler. He's not a kafir. He's an imamun zalimun jair. He's an oppressive, transgressor, unjust ruler. Listening and obeying him. There's a mafsada. The mafsada is what? You're going to by you listening and obeying this transgressive ruler, it is a form of aiding him in his oppression and his transgression. There's a mafsada, la shak. By you listening and you obeying him, there is a mafsada here, which is i'anatuhum ala dhulmihim. I mean, i'anatuhum ala dhulmihim. You're aiding the rulers in their oppression. Nah. But there's also a maslaha in there. What is the maslaha? Intidami ahwal al-jama'ah. The unity of the Muslims will be present. Wastiqrar al-ummah. The matter of the ummah will be steadfast. Their affairs will be good. this maslaha takes precedence over that mafsada. وَهَذِي الْمَصْلَحَةُ أَعْظَمْ مِنْ تِلْكَ الْمَفْسَدَةِ This maslaha will take more precedence. Because we're going to prevent the people from what? We want the unity. We want the ummah to not be disunified, disunity to occur. We don't want bloodshed, all of that. Very good. This mafsada is little, which is to aid him upon his oppression, in comparison to what, like him? In comparison, في مقابل تلك المصلحة العظيمة, when it's put in comparison to what? The maslaha. Line 15. ومن قواعد الشريعة التيسير في كل أمر نابه تعسير. The author now, رحمه الله تعالى, in the 15th line, he's talking about ومن قواعد الشريعة التيسير. From the principles of the Sharia is التيسير, to make matters easy. Taysir here, the word taysir, ma'khudun min al-yusri, is taken from the word yusr. And what does yusr mean? Yusr means as-suhulatu wal-liyunati. It means ease and simplicity. The word sharia, what does it mean in the language? The word sharia is al-mawridul azimu lil-ma. Sharia means when the water pours, the place where it goes into and it becomes large in quantity when it goes down the water. The place. That's called Sharia. The author said, وَمِنْ قَوَاعِدِ الشَّرِيعَةِ التَّيْسِيرُ فِي كُلِّ أَمْرٍ نَابَهُ Every matter, نَابَهُ ما معنى نَابَهُ أي عَارَضَهُ وَنَزَلَ بِهِ نَابَهُ means it descends on it. It comes down to it. Any matter which harsh hardness comes to it. نَابَهُ تَعْسِيرُ تَعْسِيرُ is hardship. Any matter. So the word تَعْسِيرُ is taken from the word عُسْر. And it's شِدَّة. And it's عَدَمُ السُّهُولَةِ أو الضِّيقُ وَالْحَرَجُ Hardship. Burden. And all of that. So any matter, the Sharia came to make matters easy, especially in matters which hardship has come into it. نعم. Some of the books, it says, وَمِنْ قَوَاعِدِ الشَّرِيعَةِ التَّيْسِيرُ فِي شَرْعِنَا Does it say? Does it also say فِي شَرْعِنَا? Some of the nusakh, it says فِي شَرْعِنَا. What's the evidence for this qaida? What is it? The قوله تعالى, Allah's statement in Surah Surah Alam Nashrah. Allah says, فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرَى إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرَى Ayah 6, Ayah 5 and Ayah 6. Allah also says, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ Allah wants ease for you. وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ Allah does not want hardship for you. Allah says also, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَن يُخَفِّفَ عَنْكُمْ وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا Allah wants to make matters easy for you and light. And the humans are made weak. Also the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam where he said, يَسِّرُوا وَلَا تُعَسِّرُوا Make matters easy, don't make it hard. In another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُمْ مُيَسِّرِينَ You guys were sent out to be people who are ease. وَلَمْ تُبْعَثُوا مُعَسِّرِينَ And you were not sent out to be harsh and hard. You weren't. So this qaida, that it shows us Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's wisdom. And from His mercy towards His creation is what? If a matter, hardship enters it, the religion came and it made it easy. فَإِنَّ شَرِيعَةَ تُخَفِّفُهُ وَتُيَسِّرُ لَهُمْ It takes the hardship off it and it makes it easier for them. This principle that we just mentioned, inshaAllah ta'ala, we can slightly change it into many different wordings. The first one, inshaAllah ta'ala, is anything in which hardshipness comes into it, anything which hardship comes into it, is negated in the Sharia. ما ورد من أن الحرج منفي في الشرع. The next one is the Sharia gave reasoning to some legislations to show that the reason why it legislated is for ease. Also, following up the jurisprudent rulings in the religion, you will come to realize that matters are easy, simple. Why? تَحْقِيقُ مَصْلَحَةِ الْخَلْقِ, to gain the benefits for the creation. Allah wants to make a benefit for you. Some ulama, and this is not the wording of Shaykh AbdulRahman Nasir al-Sa'di rahimahullah. AbdulRahman Nasir al-Sa'di didn't say this way that these scholars said it. Some scholars, they use this qa'idah as what? Al-mashaqqatu tajlibu taysir. They use that wording. They say al-mashaqqatu tajlibu taysir. And by the way, this qa'idah right now, al-mashaqqatu tajlibu taysir, is from the qawa'id al-kubra, from the five that are unanimously agreed upon. This one qa'idah is from the five that are unanimously agreed upon, which is al-mashaqqatu tajlibu taysir. And the previous one that we took, al-dararu yuzalu. Oh, that we're going to take it to come. Have we not taken it? No, we haven't taken it. Al-dararu yuzalu will come to us. So far from the qawa'id al-kubra, how many have we taken so far? We take al-umuru bimaqasidiha, or even that wording, innama al-a'malu binniyat. We took that one. We took the second one, which is right now, which one? We took al-mashaqqatu tajlibu taysira, sah? Ah, and we have three more to go. Some of the scholars, they say al-mashaqqatu tajlibu taysir. What does that mean? Mashaqqa, hardship. Fadal Oyan, what do you want to ask?
I think it was just asking what that means. But so you're not going to explain it.
Which one? Al-mashaqqatu tajlibu taysir. Mashaqqa means hardship. Tajlibu, it brings, and taysira, ease. That's the wording they brought. But the author didn't say that. The author, if you look at his wordings, he said, وَمِنْ قَوَاعِدِ الشَّرِيعَةِ التَّيْسِيرُ فِي كُلِّ أَمْرِ نَابَهُ تَعْسِيرُ. His qa'idah is التَّعْسِيرُ سَبَبُ لِلْتَيْسِيرُ. Ah, that's what the Sheikh said. The qa'idah he's saying is what? التَّعْسِيرُ. Ta'sir is hardship. Ah, is a reasoning for ease. Whereas the other group, what did they say? Hardship, mashaqqa, it brings what? Mashaqqa brings ease. Hardship brings ease. And the author said, التَّعْسِيرُ, hardship, sababun, it's a reason for taysir. Now there is a difference, and I don't know in English, but there's a difference between a ta'siru and al mashaqqa. And there's no doubt a difference between sababun and jalb, tajallub. There's a difference between the two, and that's what made the qa'idah incorrect. And we're gonna analyze why this qa'idah is wrong. Al-mashaqqatu tajlibu taysir. The one that a lot of the scholars use. Why is that wording wrong? For many reasons. One. The reason why it's wrong is because the evidences of the Sharia, it came to take away usr. And the religion did not come to take mashaqqa. The religion, the Sharia, it came to eradicate, to get rid of usr, and not to get rid of al-mashaqqa. Inshallah ta'ala, when the next points come, you'll realize the difference between the two, inshallah ta'ala. The second one, inshallah ta'ala, is that the ahkam of the Sharia, the rulings of the religion, the Sharia, mashaqqa is not absent from it. So the word mashaqqa would be a burden. Such as, for example, jihad. There's burden in that. There's a burden in it. And calling to the good and prohibiting the evil, there's burden in it. In the salah, there is burden in it. As Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ كَبِيرَةٌ heavy عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said about this jihad, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْجِهَادِ كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْقِتَالُ وَهُوَ كُرْهٌ لَكُمْ. And you dislike it. Why? Because it's a burden. It's a burden. So saying that the Sharia came to waking up for Salatul Fajr, doing wudu after, there's a mashaqqa in that. But is there usr in there? There is not usr in there. There is mashaqqa in there. Like him. Naam. Here we have to realize, lakin, the mashaqqa is not in the majority of the actions. Even though we said that it's still in the Shari'ah, that the mashaqqa is present in the Shari'ah, it doesn't mean that it's present in every single action. Rather, the majority of the actions don't even have mashaqqa. They don't. That's from one angle. The other angle is that this mashaqqa, which is present in some of the actions, so the majority of the actions don't even have mashaqqa in it. They don't have it. The ones that can who do, which is this, another point, which is the ones who those actions which do have mashaqqa in it, it is maqduru lil mukallafi. The servant is able to do it. It's not something outside his realm. And another point that the third point we can look at it from is what? That the maslaha in that actions outweighs the mashaqqa that is present in it. The maslaha, the benefit that is in it, outweighs the what? The mashaqqa that is present in it. And what does that mean? It's like example when a doctor prescribes for a person a medicine which smells bad and it tastes bad. There's a mashaqqa and there's hardship in, or there's a burden or a suffering from the patient's side when he has to drink this medicine. He has to close his nose, he has to take it in, he doesn't like the smell to it, he doesn't like the taste to it. But is the benefit outweigh the mashaqqa? Nah, if you don't take it, you won't get better. Of course, with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even though it tastes very bad, bitter, but the benefit that outweighs the mashaqqa here. And we also have to keep in mind, which is the third point. The third point. So I mentioned the first point, which was what? The Sharia, it did not come to negate usur. It came to negate usur. The evidences from the Sharia, it has indicated that the Sharia, it came to what? It came to get rid of usur. And it hasn't come to negate mashaqqa. The second point was that the hakam of the Sharia, you will find in it mashaqqa. And number point three, inshallah ta'ala, is أن المشقة ليس منضبطة. The mashaqqa cannot be narrowed down to something. It cannot be pinned down. What is mashaqqa? It cannot be narrowed down to a point, or it can't be narrowed down to a specific point. ولذلك, the scholars, they tried their best to say what is mashaqqa, or the dhabit for mashaqqa, and they weren't able to put anything to it. Because any action that is said this action has a mashaqqa, the actions differs. هذا أمر تختلف فيه وجهات النظر. The people see it differently. And that's why, brothers and listeners, the religion doesn't ever connect a illah, a reasoning, because of a mashaqqa. And that's what many people think when they say that matter. A lot of people, they think what? A lot of people, they attach a ruling of the Sharia to mashaqqa. For example, they say, for example, a traveler, the reason why he's allowed in the month of Ramadan, he's allowed in the month of Ramadan to break his fast, the traveler, the person who is on a journey, traveling. Why? When you ask them, they say, لِمَشَقَّة, because there's mashaqqa in it. So they make the illah, the reasoning of why the person, the fasting is uplifted from his shoulder, فَالْعِلَّةُ هِيَ, they say, الْعِلَّةُ هِيَ الْمَشَقَّةُ. The illah is because of mashaqqa. That's the reasoning. Then, automatically, a smart individual look at him and say, whoa, if that's the case then, I am a baker, and I'm all the time inside that heat. So is it permissible for me, because fasting is hard for me, I have to burn inside the heat? You see? Or the one who says, I'm a builder, I build. I'm an engineer, I build constructions, I take my hands and I build, and it's hard for me. Then what will happen is, the Sharia, a lot of ahkam will be thrown out of the window, because mashaqqa cannot be narrowed down. The one who's traveling, the one who is building the, which one would you say is a mashaqqa, and which one can you say that's not a mashaqqa? Good. So that qa'ida fihi nadar. This qa'ida, there is a look to it. And also another reasoning why we can say that this qa'ida fihi nadar, there's a look to it, is because, which will be point number four, is that the mashaqqa doesn't bring ease. How can a mashaqqa bring ease? Because their qa'ida was what? Al-mashaqqa tajribu taysir. That the mashaqqa brings ease. But that isn't the case. Who brings ease? The one who brings the ease is the Shari'ah. إِنَّمَا الْجَالِبُ لِلْتَيْسِيرُ هُوَ الشَّارِعِ. It's the Shari'ah that brings it. And that's why the author's statement, which is الْعُسْرُ أَمَا التَّعْسِيرُ سَبَبُ لِلْتَيْسِيرِ, is better. It's better. And not every single mashaqqa, as I said, brings ease. So the author said, rahimahullah ta'ala, وَمِنْ قَوَاعِدِ الشَّرِيعَةِ التَّيْسِيرُ فِي كُلِّ أَمْرِ نَابَهُ تَعْسِيرُ. If all of that which I've said has been understood, what are the types of hardship that ease are brought in it? The hardship, the usur, which the sharia allowed ease to come, or it's a means, a sabab li taysir. What is it? Marad. Number one is illness. The sharia, if a person is ill, the sharia, what did it do? It gave him an ease. Because hardship has come now on the person, the sharia has given him ease. But I want you to all ponder, inshallah ta'ala, and analyze with me this very important point, which is, Allah says in the Qur'an, in Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 196, and many people have misunderstood this. And that is why it's important to study Qawa'id Al-Fiqhiyyah. The ayah says, فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ مَرِيضًا أَوْ بِهِ أَذًا مِنْ رَأْسِهِ فَفِدْيَةٌ مِنْ صِيَامٍ أَوْ صَدَقَةٍ أَوْ نُسُكٍ. What concerns us here is, فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ مَرِيضًا. Any one of you who is fasting, any one of you who is sick. So the ayah, what does it specifically said? فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ مَرِيضًا. The ayah said مَرِيضًا. مَرِيضًا is what the ayah said. And the ayah didn't say مَنْ كَانَ بِهِ مَرَض. The ayah said what? فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ مَرِيضًا. The sharia did not say مَنْ كَانَ بِهِ مَرَض. What do they both mean in English? مَرِيضًا is the one who's sick. The one who is sick. مَرِيضًا. It is the one who is sick. And his illness, if he fasts, the fasting will cause his illness to grow. That is what's meant by مَرِيضًا. If you say مَنْ كَانَ بِهِ مَرَض, a person who illness has befallen him, then that means he is ill. But if he fasts, the fasting will not do anything to his illness. This one, he's not allowed to miss his fasting. The permissibility of breaking your fast and the sharia making this issue light for you is when the fasting will either delay the cure or your recovery, it will delay you recovering quickly, or it will even increase in your illness. As for the person who is ill, he's ill and he's recovering, and the increasing of the illness is not there. He's going to recover. The fasting won't do anything to his illness. For example, he has a toothache, or he has a headache. And the fasting won't cause anything to his head. And it won't do anything to his toothache. This individual, he is not allowed to leave the fasting. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَجُزُ لَهُ الْإِفْطَارِ. He can't break his fasting. Because the ayah says, فَمَنْ كَانَ بِهِ مَرِيضًا. نعم. The second thing, which is also from the things which the sharia gave taysir, ease. The first one was illness. The second one is السفر, traveling. The sharia, it gave ease on this one. It gave what? It gave ease, the sharia did. But the scholars disputed amongst themselves, ضابط السفر, what is considered safar? And what is safar? The scholars, they what? They disputed one another. Some of the scholars, they are from amongst them, those who said 80 kilometers is what? 80 kilometers, it's traveling. If a person travels 80 kilometers, he is traveled. Some of the scholars, they said, no, one day. They said a day. When I say day, I mean day and a night, 24 hours. And that second view, who said it's a day, 24 hours, seemed to have a very strong hold. They seem to have a very strong evidence on that. And they've got two evidences which show very strong stance. The first one is what? Surah Al-Nahl, Ayah 80. Allah says, يَوْمَ ضَعْنِكُمْ وَيَوْمَ إِقَامَتِكُمْ. The day of your traveling and the day of your residency. So Allah referred to their traveling, whilst they're a traveler, Allah referred to it for a day. He said, يَوْمَ the day. And then the next day after that, what did Allah say? وَيَوْمَ إِقَامَتِكُمْ and the day of your residency. So when they're only considered traveling for 24 hours, and then after that Allah gave them the title of residency. That's the ayah they used. And also, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the hadith narrated by Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, min hadith Abi Huraira, from the hadith of Abu Huraira, that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لا تسافر امرأة, a woman should not travel, يوماً one day, إلا مع ذي محرم, except with what? Except with a mahram. With what? So they said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, here this hadith, they said what? This hadith, that the woman should not travel a day without a mahram. And the Prophet only considered her a traveling for a day. And they said, وَلَمْ يَرِدْ أَقَلَّ مِنْ ذَٰرِكَ. And they said, less than a day has not been transmitted. They said it's not been transmitted. That's what they said. The third view is those who said, بِأَنَّ الضَّابِدُ فِي ذَٰلِكَ يَرْجِعُ إِلَى الْعُرْفِ. The third view, what did they say? The matter goes back to the custom of the people. It goes back to the urf. فَمَا عَدَّوْ أَهْلُ الْعُرْفِ سَفَرًا فَوَ سَفَرٌ وَإِلَّا فَلَا نَعُدُّ سَفَرًا تُنَاطُ بِهِ أَحْكَامُ التَّخْفِيفِ. They said that whatever the people of that land consider traveling becomes traveling, and whatever from the people of that land do not consider traveling will not be traveling. So the matter goes back to? It goes back to the custom of the people. And the third view is the strongest of all. That the matter is brought back to the urf, the custom of the people. Wherever the people consider a traveling, becomes traveling. And whatever the people do not consider traveling, is not traveling. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in the Qur'an, وَمَنْ كَانَ مَرِيضًا أَوْ عَلَىٰ سَفَرٍ فَعِدَّةٌ مِنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ. That's the evidence for that the traveling, ease has been brought for it. Because Allah said, any one of you who is sick, and any one of you who is fasting, Allah says, فَعِدَّةٌ مِنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ. Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 180. He has to bring back those days. The third one is that the Shari'ah placed a taysir on, and the Shari'ah gave taysir to, is a naqs, deficiency. Deficient in terms of sanity, deficient in terms of age, deficiency in terms of purity, like the woman, she's impure. All of those, it's taken from them. The author went on to the next line. وَلَيْسَ وَاجِبٌ بِالَقْتِدَارِ وَلَا مُحَرَّمٌ مَعَ الضِّرَارِ. Pause.